Hey guys, Spaulding here again, and this is the bronze medal matchup between Alex Wynn and Halfa in the IDC 4 tournament. Alex playing Nature Fire Rush and Halfa is playing Rub Midrange. For those of you who don't know what Rub stands for, it's for red, blue and black. Of course, the U is for blue because the B was already taken by black, and it is a common term in the trading card game, and I think it's originated in the Magic scene and also took over to other games. So yeah, Alex starting with Polygon on his first turn, already really nice having a one drop in his hand, but Polygon I think is the worst of the three one drops because it gets bounced back to the hand, and yeah, you lose quite a lot of tempo. Yeah, so really nice shield trigger for Alpha. Of course, he would have liked something like a Terra Pit, but now he can just trade into the Quixotic and also playing an energy stream. And Alex doesn't have another play, so that means he must have a Volcanic Arrows or a Common Missile in hand. And yeah, Polygon will get bounced back again, which he now realizes. Yeah, 10 cards in hand, quite a lot of options, but limited by the mana, of course. A really nice play would be something like Volcano Charger, and the second best play, yeah, the Phantom Dragon's Flame. Again, Alex Wynn with the charged polygon. He did it already in the semi-final where he charged the fourth mana, and I really don't like the charging because now he can just play his polygon again. Okay, he has Quixotic, and the other card in hand must be a Comet Missile, but yeah, he doesn't really need 4 mana, so I'm not sure what he is going for. Meanwhile, Alpha playing Coral, which is like a body on board and also giving him something like an extra turn because the creature which doesn't have speed attacker gets bounced back to the deck and you will just replay it, which gives Half an opportunity to charge one more mana the next turn and be ahead really far. Another call which would be nice here, or even something like an Amra and setting a shield trigger. I'm not sure if Half has playing a Bloody Skeeter in his build. I think he's playing two, but you have to remember that Alex probably has something like a Comet Missile in hand or maybe a Volcanic Arrows, so I would like to discard Alex first and then play the Skeeter. Charging Emerald, that must mean that he doesn't have a shield trigger in hand. And yeah, he has the Common Missile. Okay, he has another Emerald, so that's fine. So here, Halfa can just go for game if he has a Meltdown in hand. Because Alex would need something like 3 volcanic arrows in his shields to destroy the 3 attackers, and he already has 1 in mana. I'm looking in the graveyard, okay, so it is possible but highly unlikely. Yeah, and here's why Quixotic is really nice with this effect. Okay, well, gets destroyed by Phantom Dragon's Flame. Because if you would have played something like Bloody Skeeto or the Thrashcrawler first, he couldn't have killed it with a small kill spell. But so yeah, the order here really mattered for Alpha. And now he's just so far ahead and just has to play more blockers. And yeah, this seems really highly unlikely for Alex to win. Tapping another 5 mana here shortly. Yeah, but yeah, another career, really nice. And I also like that he is playing energy stream first, because you should always draw first and then make the other play, because maybe you will top deck something that you would like to play instead. Here it was really unlikely that Halfa was going for another play. Another play except the core play that he made, because it is just so strong, giving him another body and an extra turn again. But yeah, really nice ordering from Halfa. And now here's the Baza lock, and let's see, he has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 creatures, and the Baza which can attack, so he's thinking about going for game. And yeah, I really, really like this, going for game now, because the Baza Gazeel cannot be killed, and he can just see what the shields are and what shield triggers there could be, and then decide to do another play. And yeah, now it's kind of tricky. This must be volcanic arrows, and he decides if he... Oh, it is common miss. And now if he goes for the double break and hits the volcanic arrows, this is game over. Oh, is it? No. He can... Yeah, if it's 2 volcanic arrows, then it's game over. And yeah, I'm not sure what Halfa's thinking. He has to go for game, but because if he kills one creature now, he can just... Okay. Yeah, this is also fine. If he has a volcanic arrows now, he can't play it, because he will destroy his last shield, and yeah. Yeah. Yeah, really heads up play by Halfa. I think in this situation it didn't matter if he attacked with Baza in the last 2 shields, or if he attacked one by one, because if he attacks with Baza first, both needs to be volcanic arrows, and if he attacks the other way around, yeah, well, if he attacks another way around, this means it would have, yeah, also be, it would be even safer, because then even 2 volcanic arrows wouldn't help him. So yeah, really optimized play by Halfa. And here Alex doesn't have a one drop and doesn't have a two drop, so really huge disadvantage already, two turns in the game. And however, with the turn two play in Emerald, setting a shield trigger most likely. Now he starts with, yeah, I don't get the volcanic arrows. Emerald doesn't do anything. Well, maybe if he doesn't have another play, then might as well play the arrows, but I would have liked it if he just held it back for a blocker. What is he doing? Playing 5 mana with 4? 5 mana cards with 4 mana? And a Terrapid. I don't know why. Yeah, I think he already gave up attacking the set shield from Emerald first. And yeah, also with the Pyrophatter Magnus charge, I think, yeah. This game is already over. Yeah, I really don't like the just surrendering plays, just mindlessly playing his cards out by Alex. Even if he has a huge disadvantage, the possibility of winning isn't zero, so you should always, yeah, try at least. Of course, there are situations where the possibility to win is zero, but your opponent can also make mistakes, so yeah. Yeah, Helfer with only one water mana and one darkness mana, but yeah, that doesn't really matter. Yeah, Sniper Mosquito is nice here because getting back his Magnus is huge, but yeah, here comes the Bazalok and now the game sealed here, and Alex concedes, and really, really fast match, of course. Playing Nature Fire Rush is always fast, and yeah, that's why I don't like Nature Fire Rush, because the games you lose, you feel so helpless. You just, yeah, try to get on the board quickly, and if the opponent has shield triggers, you feel so crushed, and then you sit there watching your opponent gaining more card advantage every turn, and you can't do anything about it, and this is so unfun, I think, and also unfun for your opponent if you just rush him down, but oh well. Yeah, so congratulations to Halfa getting the third place in the IDC4, and let's see who wins in the grand final match between Hymne and Dark Senna. Bye.